Welcome back. Well, it's the night before the federal budget, and Treasurer Jim Chalmers joined me to speak about the cost of living, inflation, and whether there'll be a surplus. It's the only television interview he's doing today ahead of tomorrow's budget. We spoke in the last half hour, and here's what he had to say. Treasurer, thank you so much for your time this evening.
Thanks very much, Sharri, for having me back on your show.
Now, we're in a cost of living crisis. The RBA governor says that people are skipping medical appointments, others are sending their kids to school without lunch, families are even living in cars. What will you do as Treasurer to help vulnerable Australians in tomorrow's budget?
Well, really the main motivation behind this budget is people doing it tough. And we want to do more than just acknowledge that things are difficult for people right now. We're actually doing something about it. So there'll be cost of living relief in the budget. There'll be a tax cut for every taxpayer, but there'll be additional cost of living help on top of that as well, at the same time as we try and build much more housing, because that's one of the reasons why people are under so much pressure, that absence of housing.
Look, you write at the top of your notes the words 41, the first two digits of the Logan postcode where you live. You've just spoken about tax cuts. You've said that they amount to about $36 a week, the stage three tax cuts that will take effect from the 1st of July. Do you worry that this won't be enough to lift people out of the sort of extreme financial stress that they're suffering?
Oh, that's why there'll be more than the average of $36 a week. I think that's really important, that cost of living help that will come from that tax cut for every taxpayer, right up and down the income scale. All 13.6 million Australian taxpayers will get a tax cut, and 84% of those taxpayers will get a bigger tax cut than they were going to get before under the old Stage 3 plan from our predecessors. But tax cuts are not the only cost of living help in the budget. There's more help on top of that, and that's because we recognise that people are doing it tough. And really the centrepiece of this budget, it will be a responsible budget, but the centrepiece will be cost of living help at the same time as we invest in the future of our economy.